What is up, weather enthusiasts? I'm your host, Pat's Path Predictor. Let's get right into the weather. All right, so here's the situation we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. We have breaking news from you coming from the NHC. This is a Pat's Path Predictor exclusive as of right now, but we now have a new area of interest tagged in the Western Caribbean Sea, and based off of some models, this thing could really go haywire. So here's the situation. We have post-tropical cyclone Tammy approaching Bermuda, and we have a new area of interest right now in the Western Caribbean Sea. Here's what we have from the NHC. This is the post-tropical cyclone right here. A strong extratropical cyclone, formerly Tammy, associated with an occluded front, is located a few hundred miles east of Bermuda. This system is forecast to become separated from the front in the next day or so, and environmental conditions are forecast to become conducive for the low to regain tropical characteristics while it meanders over the northwestern Atlantic to the east of Bermuda through Saturday. Regardless of tropical's development, the system is likely to bring gusty rains and heavy rainfall to Bermuda during the next couple of days. Interests in Bermuda should monitor the progress of the system. For more information, check the high seas forecast by the NWS. So 50% chance of formation in the next 48 hours, 50% chance in the next 7 days. So this, the chances have been rapidly increasing. If we go ahead and show you some of the archived outlooks, like this is where we were earlier today. We were at 30-30. This morning we were at 30-30. And late last night, we were at post-tropical cyclone Tammy at that current point in time. So odds are starting to increase for this thing. But this is the system I am paying attention to right here. This area of interest, which is likely going to be designated Invest 96L, a broad area of low pressure is forecast to develop over the southwestern Caribbean Sea during the next few days. Environmental conditions could support some slow development of the system early next week while it moves generally northward over the western or central portion of this basin. 20% chance formation in the next 7 days as of right now. However, based off of some models, this could be organizing in the next 3 to 4 days or so. So this is definitely stuff we need to pay attention to, as the Caribbean Sea is the only area across the entire Atlantic that is virtually untapped by tropical stuff this year. And the reason that's kind of I'm reporting on this is because let's say this thing organizes and let's say this thing develops based off of the extremely warm waters. And we saw this with Otis just a few days ago. Based off of the extremely warm waters, the insane 200 plus OHC and wind shear of like 10 knots, this thing could explosively intensify at this current point. Keep in mind, by the time this is forecasted to even consider developing, we're still a few days out, and right now we're not 100% sure if that's going to happen or not, but based off of all the conditions I'm seeing in the Caribbean Sea over the next few days, there is a pretty good chance that this is a possibility. So with that being said, we're going to go ahead and start showing you some model runs because you guys need to get all the big stuff that's coming out. Here's what we have. We're going to start with the European, go through that, the GFS, ICON, CMC, NavGem, all those models as time continues to go on, to kind of give you an understanding of what we're looking at right here. Here's the European model at this current point in time. The European has post-tropical cyclone Tammy approaching Bermuda and just kind of meandering over there. However, it is starting to show some signs of organization and potential development in the next 3 days or so. We're starting to see a registered low pressure system start to fire up in the Central Caribbean Sea as it approaches Jamaica as either a tropical depression or a tropical storm before moving off towards Cuba and then towards the Atlantic Ocean and the Bahamas over there. The Europeans having a hard time really looking at this and really designating this at this current point in time. So in the next few mile runs, we'll have to see how that plays out. But other models have been picking up on this very early on, one of which being the GFS model. And here's what we have according to the GFS. The GFS is showing signs of organization and development in the next 3 days, starting around October 29th. So the NHC is finally picking up on the stuff that we were reporting here on Pat's Path Predictor over the last couple of days when it comes to this stuff. And this thing is starting to show signs of organization and potential development as it makes landfall in Haiti as a tropical storm and just kind of meanders over there. And then we start to see the real big stuff start to come up and start firing off as time continues to go on, as another low pressure system starts to organize and develop, a much larger low pressure system rather. And then by about 10 days out, we're starting to see some registrations of hurricane strength at that current point in time. We're at 276 hours out at the time this thing really gets organized and then starts to make its approach towards Florida by November 8th. Keep in mind, by the time the scenario plays out, by the time we get to this frame, we're about 13 days out. So take that with a huge grain of salt. At this current point, we don't know exactly what's going to happen, but we are preparing for it as time continues to go on. If we go ahead and kind of show you the wind shear and dry air in association with this, according to what the GFS is showing, we can get a better idea of what's been going on. If we can go ahead and get the relative humidity, here it is right here. Very moist Caribbean Sea through much of this. About I'd say 72 hours out, this is where we're at. Very moist part of the Caribbean Sea where this thing starts to develop. There's a huge dry air pocket across much of the Gulf of Mexico. However, that is forecast to considerably weaken down as time continues to go on. And then by the time this thing really starts to take off and really starts to become this massive low pressure system, there's a huge, huge pocket of moist air this thing is going to be developing in. And it's going to be enough to really cancel out what the Gulf of Mexico is going to be bringing, at least until the last second, if this is the case. If we go ahead and show you the wind shear in association with this, the Gulf of Mexico, the wind shear in the Gulf is absolutely volatile. However, the wind shear across much of the Caribbean Sea is actually quite good for development, and this is what's concerning me because we all saw this with Otis, like I just said. We all saw the extremely good conditions that this stuff is going to be in. Right now in the Caribbean Sea, where this thing is expected to develop, we are in 30-plus degrees Celsius or 86-plus degree waters across this entire region where this thing has been tagged by the National Hurricane Center. For those of you who do not know how much that really factors into it, well, we all saw that a few days ago, and if you wanted to see that, check out Hurricane Otis and check out the instant replay with all the satellite data with that, because that's what happens when these things take full advantage. If we go ahead and take a look at the OHC, over 200 on its way to Jamaica at that current point in time, and we're seeing still areas of over 200 OHC across much of the Caribbean Sea. And this is why I'm paying very much attention to this, because this whole system right here, this whole area where this system is going to be at, is untapped. Even in October, we're still seeing extremely warm waters. We're still seeing record warm waters across this whole thing, and we're still seeing very record OHC. And that is absolutely scary as someone looking at this, because at this point, this is a ticking time bomb. And if it's not going to happen this year, it's going to happen next year. It only takes one system for it to move through those waters, intensify it at a very fast rate, and then hit somewhere with a large population, and then all hell will break loose. That's what we have going on with the Caribbean OHC wind shear, as we were kind of talking about where it is right now. Good wind shear for this thing to start developing. So that's why I'm particularly worried about it at this current point in time. That's the GFS model that we have to show you at this point. Now we're going to go ahead and show you the CMC model. The CMC has been really pulling some interesting scenarios out, to say at the very least. CMC has been showing some signs of organization and development and development as this thing enters the Caribbean Sea. And by the time it does enter there, it already has a pretty good start about a week out. We're at a strong tropical storm strength before moving back into Central America, at least from the latest the CMC is bringing. If we go ahead and show you the 0-0-Z of that, and showing another interesting situation where the CMC is actually having this thing becoming a tropical storm before approaching Mexico. Yeah, these paths are a bit wonky if you ask me, so we'll have to see how that plays out. But I want to check the ensembles. I want to check the CMC's ensemble runs to kind of get a better understanding of what maybe they're thinking about all this. And here's the CMC's ensembles at this current point in time, showing quite a bit of scenarios of tropical storm to hurricane strength. Look at how many scenarios there are at this current point, about 90 hours out from the CMC. So this is definitely something you need to pay attention to. The ensembles, there's basically like 30 different runs from the CMC, and each run is basically a certain scenario of how what may be playing out. And based off of these scenarios, I'm counting at least, what, 15 to 20 scenarios of something happening, something potentially large happening. So yeah, it's definitely not off the table from what I'm seeing. And even the European and GFS ensembles are also picking up on this, albeit at a smaller scale in the case of the European. Just as many ensembles are picking up on it, but it's not nearly as strong as what we were seeing with the CMC. If we go ahead and show you the GFS ensembles, they're a bit concentrated as well. They're a bit more concentrated than the other ones, so we'll have to see how that whole thing plays out as time continues to go on. Those are the ensemble runs that I've been watching at this current point in time. Next thing we're going to go ahead and show you is the NavGem model. The NavGem has been one of those models that, to be honest, isn't the best in the world, but it is a good indicator on what could happen. And it's been a model in the rotation that's actually been performing decently well this season. So here's what we have from the 12C NavGem. Right now, not much happening. Then about 3 days later, showing signs of organization and development potentially in the Caribbean Sea. While it kind of takes its time to get its act together, and we don't exactly see that much according to the 12Z. If we go ahead and show you the 0Z, we do see some potential low pressure system starting to really get its act together, but the NavGem's not been really picking up on this just yet. I think the NHC's designation of this is going to change a little bit on the NavGem side. Last model we're going to go ahead and show you is the Icon model. Icon model's been a pretty consistent model, to say at the very least. So we'll have to see what it's doing with it. And the Icon is showing signs of organization already, and potentially some development into a tropical storm as it approaches Jamaica before making landfall there. And from about 108 hours out, it's a little hard to detect what the Icon is doing, primarily because this is such a new designation from the NHC. And once this thing does get designated as an invest, we'll get some more detail and we'll have better information on how this whole thing plays out. But I will tell you this, and I think Otis gave us a stark reminder of this, and this is something I've been warning for months on end. Models are one thing, but real-time raw conditions are a whole other ballpark. Anything can happen in this world. We saw a 50-mile-per-hour tropical storm rapidly intensify into a Category 5 hurricane with winds of 165 miles per hour and then make landfall in Acapulco, which is a city with a metropolitan area of well over a million people. We've seen stuff like this happen, and this is why I'm taking it so seriously, because of what's been happening in other parts where the models really haven't been paying much attention. And with that being said, we will keep you updated on every step of the way of this, but we are going to close the video out right now. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It helps us out, helps us make more videos like these. The goal of this channel is to get more people engaged with weather. And with that being said, have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe.